Program to find the sum of integers read from keyboard until the user enters 50. If any entered number is 9, that need to be subtracted. That is, a sample output is shown here. If the numbers entered are like this, 10, 15, 5, 9, 6, 12, 25, 9, and 15, on entering the number 50, it must stop the operation of reading the numbers. And the operation that is to be performed is like this. Whenever there is a 9, that need to be actually subtracted from the results. So only 9 need to be subtracted, everything else need to be added. And one more thing, on entering a 50, it must stop the operation and do this operation accordingly. So for this particular example, we will get a result equal to 105. So let's look at the solution of this. This is a program actually to display the numbers like this, that is to enter the numbers. I am giving a prompt like number 1, number 2, number 3, etc. So for having this count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to n, I am giving the counter as I. Okay, for the counter I am using I, that is initialized to 1 because I am starting from number 1. And another number, now another variable n is also declared to read the numbers one by one. Then to find the sum, I am using s. So that is initialized to 0. And here I am using the do while loop. So as you know, for a do while loop, do is written first, then after the set of operations, the condition is checked. As I have to quit from the loop of entering the numbers and doing the operations on entering a 50, I am giving the condition as while n not equal to 50. So while n not equal to 50, the operations will be continued, that is reading the different numbers and performing the operation addition or subtraction based upon the entire number is 9 or not. Okay, so as long as I am not entering a 50, it will continue in the loop. So that is the condition given here, while n not equal to 50. Inside the do while loop, I am first printing the prompt number 1. It will print number 1. I have given an I plus plus here. Why? Because I can have this I here and this I plus plus at the next line, but I can write the I plus plus here itself, because this I plus plus actually the value of I will be incremented after this operation. Okay, value of I will be incremented only after executing the current statement. So in the current statement, it will print the value of the current I, because it will print 1 itself. Okay, it will print while executing this statement, it will print 1, and on going to the next line only its value is incremented. On going to the next line means after executing that current statement only, it will increment the value of I. So that is a difference between a pre-increment and a post-increment operation. So if it was a plus plus I, the value is first incremented and printed. That means on the place of this number 1, I will get a number 2 here. Instead of this number 1, it will print a number 2 if I use plus plus I. But as I have used I++, it will print 1 itself. Okay. And then only it will increment the value of I to 2. So after printing the current value 1, it will increment the value to 2. Okay. So then it is scanning the first number. So percentage %d ampersand %n will read the first value 10 to n. So to do the operation, we have the plus operation as well as the minus operation based upon whether the entered number is 9 or not. If 9 is entered, I have to use the minus symbol. So I am checking if n not equal to 9. So if the entered number is not 9, we have to add the number with the sum. Sum is initially 0, so I am adding the value with the already existing value 0. So 9 is stored in S. Else I am subtracting the value from S. That means if it is equal to 9, it is subtracting from here. That means the first iteration, it is actually adding the value to S. That means S is equal to 10 in the first iteration, because S is equal to 0 plus 10. That means S is equal to 10 now. Okay. And it comes here, checks the condition. So entered number is not 50. It is going back here and it is printing number 2, because the I was incremented to 2. So number 2. And after printing number 2, it will increment the value of I to 3. Okay. And I'm scanning the second number. The second number ended is 15. Okay. So second number ended is 15. So here also n is not equal to 9. 15 is not equal to 9. So what happens is 10 plus 15 is done. S is already 10. So 10 plus 15 is performed. That means 25 is stored in S. Okay. So in this way, the loop will continue. And whenever a number not equal to 9 is entered, it will add with the S. And if the entered number is 9, it will subtract from S. Only that thing is needed to be done inside this if else statement. So on entering a 50 at the end, to exit from the operation, we have to enter a 50. So on seeing a 50, it will print the sum of numbers S. I hope you understood this operation. So if you have any doubt, you can write it there in the comment box, or you may contact me. Thank you.